Hey guys, it's Josh from JTech. Today I'm going to show you how the TXV AC system works. We'll start here at the compressor. Here at the compressor, there's a pulley that's driven by the motor. As the motor turns, there's a magnetic plate attached to it. When that engages, it turns a shaft inside of the compressor, which is attached to a wobble plate, which moves the pistons up and down like that. On the low side here, you have a low pressure, low temperature liquid, which is sucked up. And before it gets sucked completely into the compressor, there's a pressure control valve here that regulates the amount of refrigerant entering and exiting the compressor. So it enters, comes over here to this side, and it's being pushed out to a high pressure, high temperature vapor. As it comes all the way here to the condenser, it gets cooled off by the fan, and then it also usually is mounted in the front of the vehicle, so there's also wind from the vehicle blowing across that corner now. Cools down into a liquid. All the way down here, past your service port, and then there's a fixed orifice tube here. Goes into the fixed orifice tube, the small, very small orifice, and when it comes off the other side, it becomes a vapor. That vapor then travels to the evaporator, where it's evaporated. It cools down, and this becomes about 5 degrees Fahrenheit. You have your air intake that blows across that. It doesn't show here, but there's a blend door here that changes where it goes through your vents and your hose. And as it's evaporating, it trickles down here to your accumulator. Now, what happens here? This filters your refrigerant, but it dumps it down here. Right here, this is a liquid. Above, this is where all the vapors are. This tube right here is positioned at the top, so it can only take in the vapors from the top of your accumulator. It sucks the low pressure, low temperature vapor in here, back to your compressor, and it makes it drown again. We're going to compare this to the TX valve operation. It's a little bit different of an operation with that, and I'll explain that next video. Hey guys, Josh from JTech again, and I'm going to show you how the TX valve AC system works. As you can see, it's a little bit different than the fixed orifice tube. The first thing you want to point out is there's not an accumulator to put a compressor on the low side. There's a receiver dryer on the high side of this AC system, and I'll explain that in a second. So we'll go through it like we did last time. You've got your pulley here with the magnetic plate. It engages. Turn the piston down here with the wall plate. Low pressure, low temperature. Vapor is sucked into this side, pushed out at a high pressure, high temperature. Vapor through here, it's a condenser. It's cooled off. It's a high pressure, high temperature liquid. Down through here. And then we're going to come up here to the receiver dryer. Now, instead of like the accumulator, it was sticking in vapor from the top part of the accumulator, this dumps the liquid down here into the receiver dryer. This also filters the refrigerant as well. The tube is positioned here at the bottom, so it's sucking up the high pressure, high temperature liquid up through here to your TX valve. This is the biggest difference in this AC system. So what happens, this all is pressurized. So it's going to come up here, push against this TX valve, it moves this way, and when it does, it lets refrigerant come through your evaporator program, cool down and evaporate. But it closes also whenever there isn't enough pressure pushing. So it regulates more efficient. It regulates the amount of refrigerant coming in and out of your evaporator. Inside the TX valve, there's a little small orifice that atomizes the refrigerant just like a fixed orifice tube. But like I said, it's more efficient because it's regulated by the pressure of these systems. So just like before, it comes through the evaporator door where it's cooled down and air blows through your intake, blends more here into your vents. There is a negative thermal coefficient being inside of the evaporator port. Basically what that does is regulates the temperature of the evaporator so it doesn't freeze. If the pressure kept running constantly, this eventually will freeze, but because there's the negative thermal coefficient in there, it doesn't. TXV system works. Thanks for watching my video.